genocide going is welcoming a larger genocide still strong now. The advantage is Venezuela, Western sanctions regime ensures state failure and instability. That's Fazio. In 17, Trump said the UN was prepared to take new action against the socialist dictatorship of Nicolas Maduro. Washington already imposed financial sanctions against Venezuela. Trump and I briefed them on the core of the new destabilizing covert offensive that would facilitate humanitarian, militaristic intervention in Venezuela and Venezuela core. 4 years of wide-ranging four-generational war against Venezuela, including simultaneously linked in Italy, psychological warfare, economic financial war, using hoarding and shortages by 20 transnational from the food and iron pharmaceutical sanctions, inflation, and the exchange rate in the markets to wreck the economy and increase the country's risk rating as weapons of war. The military should do well not waver in its effort to overthrow Maduro. Such maneuvers would be aimed at accelerating Madam Madison McMaster and Kelly's plans to produce regime change in Venezuela if the option would prosper. It would certainly transform South America into a new Afghanistan. Now, Venezuelan instability leads to Latin American and global instability, economic insecurity, instability, Latin America institutional credibility decline, narco trafficking, and organized crime. That's McCarthy in 17. Collapse would trigger greater instability for Venezuela's neighbors, Colombia, Brazil, and the Caribbean. These countries are likely to experience the effects of higher levels of massive out-migration. Venezuela's collapse would send a negative message about the broader state of affairs, with throwing a question of crisis management capacity of regional bodies, particularly for the UN, ASEAN, but also the OAS. Collapse would threaten the hard-won hemisphere gains in terms of progress towards more secure and stable environment, financial disruption of Venezuelan oil markets, exacerbation of already complex security challenges regarding transnational crime. Now, failed state struggle with zero-sum leads to human rights violations, torture, poverty, starvation, disease, human trafficking, WMD proliferation, genocide, and anarchy. That's man warring and five process leading to state failure's most dangerous long-term security challenge facing global community. Failed state status, the breeding ground for instability, criminality, insurgency, regional conflict, terrorism, host evil networks of all kinds, whether they involve criminal business enterprises, narco trafficking, murder, kidnapping, corruption, intimidation, destruction of infrastructure, means of coercion, persuasion, spawn, human rights violations, torture, poverty, starvation, disease, recruitment, abuse of child soldiers, trafficking, and women in body parts, trafficking, proliferation of conventional weapon systems, WDs, genocide, ethnic cleansing, warlordism, criminal anarchy, racial systems, syndromes of poverty, destabilization, conflict, failing in failed states, so we do not go where virtually anyone can take advantage of failed state, comes in dysfunctional states, rogue states, criminal states, narco states, or in the new people's democracies. Now, hunger, malnutrition, and starvation in Venezuela now. That's Grant Harrison, 17. Hunger is not in Venezuela. 31 million people short of food. Pangs of hunger fell throughout the quarters. The major business hospitals and schools where children fainted due to skip classes. 3/4 of the Venezuelans lost weight. 3 out of 9 or 10 homes can't cover the cost of what they should eat. And 10 million people skip at least 1 million. 1 meal percent of children showing signs of acute malnutrition decline from 8% last October to 12% in July. Now, food insecurity causes civil wars, hunger, state failures, instability, terrorism, proliferation, disease, economic collapse, and extinction. That's Brown in 9. Agricultural tensions generate breakdown of the governments and societies for shortages could bring down not only the individual governments, but also global societies. As demand for food rises faster than supplies are growing, that resulting food price inflation puts severe stress on the governments of countries. Hey, if the food situation continues to deteriorate, entire nations will break down the ever-increasing rate states fail, and the national governments can only provide for the food security and basic social services. Our global civilization depends on functioning network of political healthy and nation states control the threat. The infectious disease managed the international monetary system that follow threat the stability of global civilization itself. Now, we have an ethical obligation to mitigate famine. That's Lawful Latin 3. They claim we have a strong obligation to actuate the starving need of even if we had eventually become malnourished. To survive knowing that others were crossed overboard and see starvation would signify an indignity and callousness worth an extinction would be morally preferable to die than to continue living at the expense of starvation. Now, solvency plan. The International Monetary Fund should provide Venezuela with debt relief. Debt cancellation is the first priority of developmental assistance. That's Jewel. And 12. Situations which corrupt regimes receive loans from the IFIs by little lenders and multilateral lenders in order to support the West geopolitical objectives rather than satisfying the needs of the citizens where creditors take advantage of systemic vulnerability and make inappropriate loan commitments rather than unfairly burdening developing nations which cancel debt or alleviate the economic pressure on the developing nations allowing them to better fund the social service programs and infrastructure projects as well as service legitimate debt to responsible lenders. Now skip the next Jubilee card. IMF can solve for Venezuela's debt economic crisis. That's McCoffin 17. Venezuela, natural advantage of its water and the country now faces the humanitarian crisis. Current economic and social disorder and Venezuela calls for re-engage with the international financial institution pragmatic approach could unlock billions of dollars in aid and debt relief in Mexico, Colombia, Chile, and others when they borrow from Iran is in the 34% range of the 10-year bond denominated in U.S. dollars, which is a fraction of Venezuela's current financing cost. Here's the fact that financial policy delivered by these countries encompass steady macroeconomic management, effective investment, infrastructure, human development, dedication, economic diversification, support, market mechanisms, and sustained efforts to build deep local savings pool to reduce dependency on foreign capital. Venezuela can fall suit. Venezuela should be able to unlock significant financial assistance from the international community to meet humanitarian needs and support reorientation of the economy. Several billions of dollars assisted by the amount of the assistance from the IMF with debt restructuring should be a particular interest. Venezuela's the IMF share a common interest in broad and successful debt operation to serve the country's cash and their support economic and social stabilization of the salary working Venezuela. No debt swap, no IMF, and if Venezuela re-engaged with the international community, it should find that there's strong support for debt restructuring once the economy is back on track. The IMF could be repaid and debt was here from San Jose's temporary condition. Now, Status quo debt repayment schedules can entrench poverty. That's Jubilee and O'Day. Their loans have been debt burdening income and conditions. These programs are a structural adjustment program. SAPs consists of measures designed to help a country repay its debts by earning more hard currency. SAPs to produce debt has some good effect, but in most favor, worse than the economic situation. In order to obtain more foreign currency, SAPs have to spend less on health, education, social services, develop national currency, catch up to wages for foreign workers in the government, industries, and services encouraged by privatization of public industries, including sale to foreign investors.
So how does like the IMF like provide debt relief for two minutes for
like what's the function? Or?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So the IMF would restructure their debt to make it so that they do not have to pay their outstanding loans.
Is it through like does the IMF do it through a loan?
No, it does not.
Like how does it restructure the debt?
There is a fairly lengthy process that the IMF goes through that I'm not entirely familiar with. However, I know that it involves the diplomatic renegotiation of loans that are outstanding to countries that they owe debt to.
Okay, so does this involve like a loan, or, like a grant or something? Like
no.
how does
it's not.
Okay, and then so how is like how does the IMF constitute like nations?
Yeah, so like almost I think every wealthy nation is involved in the IMF. China, the European Union, the United States, Australia, etc.
Okay,
they are a collection of nations, which means that they would be acting in order to relieve debt for a foreign nation.
Okay, sure. Let's go into your raving about cost benefit analysis. Why is it good for the government to like use, or why is like,
good?
Huh?
Why is
yeah,
it good?
Yeah, like why is it good?
So there are a couple of arguments.
Okay.
Reserves and Livermore says that governments have an obligation to protect the aggregate well-being of society. It also says that
so
governments.
So what does that entail?
It means you have to aggregate society into like a pool and then decide what is best for that group of people, right? And that aggregation usually results
so
in the same.
How do we decide what's best for like a group of people?
Yeah, so that's also the reserves and Livermore evidence. The second claim is the statistical compassion claim. It says that every life is uniquely valuable, which means we have to preserve life at all costs.
Okay, so how is like, can you explain how every life is like uniquely valuable?
Yeah, every life has inherent meaning and value, which means that we all live and function on this earth. We all,
why does that mean
to
that
some extent, cooperate.
How's there inherent,
one another?
Like, why is life like uniquely like good then? Like, just because we exist?
Yeah, it's because we exist. We function. We cooperate with one another.
Why?
Trades,
why does existing mean that life is good?
I mean, if your argument is that
no, I'm just asking.
Life is bad.
I'm not saying like life is bad. I'm just like asking like why that justifies.
I'm not sure.
Like, why does existing justify like goodness?
That's what the Resets and Livermore evidence says. It says that existence
so
of life proves that life is valuable.
Wait, the Livermore evidence just says that, like, we should, like, government should just, like, act and, like, whereas, like, cost-benefit analysis. Like, how does that, like, which line in the card says that?
It says we exercise statistical compassion by recognizing what numbers of lives saved represent living beings in each compared to their lives.
Okay.
I'll start with that. 34.
Merriam-Webster defines nation as an area of land that's controlled by its own government. Interpretation. Merriam-Webster defines nation as an area that's controlled by its own government. Interpretation. Development assistance only encompasses public grant, loan transfers. Comments 92. Development assistance defined by the DAC includes only public transfers with the grant. NMIB debt cancellation is not a grant or loan, and that was conceded in cross examination. Violation via AFU, and the another violation that the AFU uses the IMF, which is just a group of wealthy nations, which is not even a group of wealthy nations, just a group of nations, multiple nations, and it doesn't control. It's not a land that is controlled by its own government. It's just a an international organization, which means it's which means it doesn't constitute one. And standards, limits are best for education, iterative hunger, mastery, conditions are best for success, restricting iterations of argument, production, presentation, review, repeatedly engaging debates about the same core issues. Trial students innovate and add their arguments based on feedback from opportunities just when there are only a few debates about each case over the course, because there's so many different cases of these immense educational benefits are lost, and they explode, limit, they're able to depend on literally any international organization as an actor, as long as it includes some wealthy countries. It basically means that it explodes limits, and also explodes limits because it clarifies any form of developmental assistance. It's not even developmental assistance, which means it doesn't meet the resolution that explodes, and it literally allows for any type of policy, which means that we're also behind in prep, and prep new answer research, which requests the status quo and delve into a large case that turns into a shallow debate that produces argumentation that brought these to disagree with everything the force of pricks, or bring generic to frivolous degree, because the negative will never be able to properly prep at the limits of bounds of the absolute dishonor bounds, and most valuable part of the right rigorous testing that's inaccessible to any other educational space. Anyone gets into a competing article, but the process class one side is well, the only one the debate provides, and C class only the app of the grant making one side discussion this terms death that I can't meaningfully get a class for make the best end of the too many S and D predictability. You're always better prepared in case allowing them to cherry pick countries that size so generic. There's thousands of cases which I would have to prefer making possible for me to guess which case my opponent running even to say disclosure solved the disclosure practice doesn't prevent breaking of new apps or the changing of key evidence in cases avoiding the negative access to prep and to as I say grant website by ignoring the definition of all the nation the app is able to explode African green and all prep burden on already huge topic and are also able to defend any policy. Remember that two policies that explode limits twofold and grants battle to produce fair debate so both sides have valuable and defensible ideas to put forward and devote as vote affair to the judge needs to force competitive actions of their role of value to the winner. And education that the game itself is valuable since teachers about the topic and other portable skills a lot by high outside of which could be further to make the game worth playing to drop the beta rate, dropping the army same, dropping the burst and get rid of the app and the B serves a different the community interpretation that reasonably least race of bonds and people cause each other and be increasingly abusive arguments and reasonably these opportunities we don't reasonable as a matter of judgment prediction and around unjustified threshold. No RBI the actual one for being toppled the FD burden producing because he can pick the one AC it's a stock issue, chills topic all to fear the laws, discouraged debates from round theory that I checked abuse and encourage the good theory because one of the use of the debate team and when the round abuse of theory argues into debate on theory since substance view until the species has been to go on these other videos, which is why substance education and a second off. Party reduction and other development methods work through emotional identification in order to produce a feeling of conservative distance and security breeding with Zontamon and Pity Cornwall 2K5. And as poor people have a voice and choice, the use of various storyline that situate themselves as guardians and rightness of champions of progress of storyline comes combined with powerful myth about the desirability of donor coordination to single calls to action, and what we can do and mix into agents of the possible development methods that work through emotional identification. Argument has this faster here that is, but it's secondary to something that is quite a different order of right. Feel of action is backed by the creation of normative institutions, the spirit of charity of unstated position, the victimhood and victim asking calls of poverty in the name of, the status and fair charity of. Affirm status position of victimhood, start to ask the cause of poverty, and the name of presenting the West as moral actors, RK 2K10. I'm working on the amount of purchases, charities, emotion, depending on the mutual recognition of inequality, the marching emotion, marks, vision, does not reason for our vision, but reinforced by burning emotional and moral valuation of our personal relationships. A Western did the same thing on a global scale, without the acknowledgement that this global society is structurally stratified. And when they cause themselves a master data policy, they create a new reality, which must still run the idea form, which makes their plan possible to drive towards purification, explanation with the will to truth, and adapt to escape suffering and create potential in the gates of life, 2K3. The Christian world to apparent and become being and becoming the Christian of his own mind, imagine another more valuable world is a question of hatred and people that makes one suffer results in asceticism looking for another one to escape from this world, supposed to change the causes of suffering, a reason is the cause of the world to narrow the world's eye, existence ought to be the will to truth is unproductive because results in the avoiding the world, is it ought to be the way out of its will to life rather than the truth overcome through a dynasty in relationship to existence, and against such an order, you should run the free spirit of traveling with the, toying with the slavish life framework of life is the only positive choice of New Age 1873. The freedom, like, scriptures will have to be good to the immense framework of which a needy man plays another one of his scaffolding when he smashes the framework to pieces of geometry and no need of a matrix of diligence by shattering and mocking the old readers, something quick and creatively the impression of the powerful present institution, and the affirmative can always identify a particular threat where exists in the integrity of the affirmative, dearly read, the desire for mastering called response to the inherent conditions, lines of domestication of the world, attempts to find the unknown, this isn't just about death, even though we all die, but the part of play and make it valuable, the act of putting negates our ability to affirm and create, making us born creatures without as much value, the framework of life makes extinction desirable, Nietzsche 1886. The cold freedom we see all men is making self far, you make us far, we can look at your compassion, no anxiety, which have understood compassion, you want to do it with suffering, your well being, the way that you understand there's no world that to that old plan, something that which makes our destruction desirable, is only the suffering which has created the all things that which raise man up, the alternative to affirm destiny and chance, you should take the risk of exposing yourself to violence, and prevent the desire for mastering control, and busy, unknown, and familiar aspects of your life, by speaking to one, you see the first stage of waiting for with the sort of enemies, sort of alternative is only good to live life mentally, and eventually through rolling the die, blue 83. The dice is thrown, the die that falls back, with these two moments of a single broken temple, you abandon life in order to fix temple, you fix our gaze upon it, the dice that affirms you coming, it is not a matter of several dark theory, which finally produces the same combination, the matter of a single dice, where the dice is the affirmation of chance, as a unit does not suppress, deny multiple seeming necessity, does not suppress, or revolve, shanty, each returns a chance, one affirmation, one each calls, destiny is a combination of chance, some necessity, to align with it, as much as chance, the bad plan, reduces causality, probability, produce a combination, it is desirable, because the combination itself is a end to be attained, to evolve, change, or operation, the bad plan, resolve on the repetition of those, although we have to be attained, are more or less probable, well, to none, the universe has no purpose that has no end, output, any more than it has positive, you know, that the certainty necessary to play well, the death are filled, because chance has not been affirmed, down, they fatal combination, fatal love, and we're not the return, but the repetition of the die throw, the nature of the fatally attained number, and to affirm chance in the tragic of life, to see the best in the world, and what is necessary, the liberation of the free and life, control, cause of life, and when I see to lose 83 dinosaur firms, even the most bitter suffering, the students of tragic one anguish and disgust, the superior is always at the point one can become an object of joy, the tragedy, attraction is only found in multiplicity, this joy is not a result of recognition, the tragic is the aesthetic form of joy, the tragedy is immediately joyful, the artist with the sun is also reborn with the rebirth of tragedy, according to the true renaissance, in order to liberate the tragic from all fear, pity, tragedy, not bound in relation of life in the next two, but the essential relation of joy and multiplicity and the positive and multiplicity, affirmation, multiplicity, and quick framing argument, presumption closed, now you have no use of the impacts of your burning within the atlas, nothing you are not the vote, not in presumption, all the impact of it in both worlds. The only problem considered is the ideal endorsed by answer to the question. The affirmative says life is not worth loving. We say it is mean you vote nag. Even if the affirmative case all case by resolve as the underlying power is not allowed the alternative, the only world without blame, the which removes the draft conflict and the prerequisite probably be always case resolve as the only fact is the question of why we well the reason why we live without reason love, there's no will to stop you say extreme mass, extension is relevant and natural. That's not value life, that's the meaning of life. You know, often we'll die mentally only about when you come back, mass extension is relevant. I control the internal link to all the case, in fact, the recreated by the decision to try and control the ground there, and that rooted in the Socratic ideal that creates balance in the pursuit of the real world. Not only increases the amount of their impact or arguments on how cost-benefit analysis is ethical is misguided, that assumes that a life is worth living for these reasons, that we must concentrate to avoid extinction, and these that we must try to preserve life. However, those arguments are misguided, which means it disproves it. We also say that the type of policymaking you talk about is bad because policymaking just dispossesses our agency and also creates resentment, and resentment is the only impact, which means that the arguments they talk about don't matter. Cost-benefit analysis assumes that that is actually good, and they says we have an ethical obligation to stop hunger. Once again, this assumes that, isn't that sort of things matter if we talk about how, like, Zonma's the only thing that happens.
Quickly, did you go in case?
Yeah.
Right. So, the alternative, what is it?
The alternative?
Yeah.
So the alternative is an affirmation of destiny and chance, right? Would you like me to explain that?
I think I get it. It's just reject the app, right?
No.
Okay, what is it?
Right. So, the affirmative says that, the world sucks, but, like, what we're saying is that, like, we, rather than, like, trying to, like, change that, we should accept that and, like, use that as, like, part of ourselves, accept
yeah.
that
so
as part
nine
of ourselves.
Out of 10 Venezuelans cannot afford food that they need. 60% of them are starving. Most of them are in the streets. Do you think that they would, like...
Right, so the West, like, we're talking about, like, for example, the Cornwall 2K5 evidence makes it clear that the reason why, like, the West or, like these types of nations intervene in these
not
places...
Not answering my question.
Yeah, no,
I'm
explaining,
specifically.
Yeah, sure, I'm explaining that, right?
But answer specific to Venezuela, that's my question.
Yeah, no, sure. I'll explain that, right? So
do Venezuelans want to die?
No, I'm explaining.
Do Venezuelans want to be in poverty?
Sure, I'm explaining like the argument here,
sure.
right? So when the West intervenes, it is trying to say that like, oh, like I have like the moral high ground, like I am like it defines itself in opposition to the Venezuelans, and therefore like it like generates like resentment in those places. The
not
reason why
my question. Do Venezuelans want to be starving in the streets, or do they want to die from
the argument is that like the only reason why life matters is in our ability to affirm it.
Sorry? Wait, what?
The only reason why life matters is in our ability to affirm it.
That's fine.
If, Resentment is generated by like creating like opposition, like basically like existing in opposition to
what is resentment?
What is resentment? The hatred of the circumstances of one's life, and like assigning of like projection of blame.
So explain that. Sorry.
The hatred of the circumstances of one's life and like and assigning
what's the impact.
The impact of resentment, like resentment, is the only impact.
That's just it.
Like resentment is the impact.
Just the hatred of life.
It's, yeah.
Okay. So
hatred
back to
of
my
circumstances
original question.
Of life. Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. So you said something about how the person whoever is relieving aid. You said something about that. Can you explain?
Okay.
You said,
sure.
Yeah.
Sure. So the argument is that like the way the app does is like, oh, like my life is good, like, oh, sure, like, so I should like try and like help these like other people, that puts them at a position of like inferiority.
So
and that generates
that
resentment.
Life in Venezuela
like,
is
they're
than
like, they basically like define themselves in
is
opposition
life
to the Venezuelans, right?
Is
like,
life,
your life sucks,
sure.
And therefore mine
Venezuela,
is good.
Yeah.
And I need to give my life.
Is life in Venezuela better than life in the United States?
What?
Is life in the United States, or is life in Venezuela better?
That, I don't, like, that's not relevant, right?
No,
because,
it's
like,
completely relevant.
Like, no,
your
it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if it's, like, better or worse. Like, our argument is that, like, you should just affirm life. Like, these types of, like, suffering, like, these things are, like, intrinsic to life. Your eradication
so
of, like,
starvation
these,
is intrinsic to life?
Yeah, suffering is intrinsic to life.
Cool. Well, let's start it now. Is there any external impact to resentment?
What do you mean?
Is there any external impact to resentment?
What do you mean? Like, does it lead to something? Or?
Yes.
Yeah, resentment is like the root cause of like all conflict.
What did you get on the case debate?
Responses to like the cost benefit analysis and then
did you read any of the questions?
No.
Okay.
saving and sending.
Tell me when everyone gets it. Order is going to be case in the order of framing and then the advantage, then T, then the K. Everyone good?
While some suffering is inevitable, it is a question of degree. Their flippant explanation of life comes from a point of privilege. It's not assumed delivery. All the people in Venezuela dying of hunger at the status quo. I'm going to go to the libel line here. The first argument is that the K solves the case. I'll answer this below. The second argument, all of the arguments for the K, I'll answer on the K. The root cause debate will be answered on the K. They say that we all die inevitably, which means that there's no difference. However, we don't all die now, and there is a difference between natural cause and all nuclear war and disease. The affirmative explanation of this argument is that failed states cause to things like WMD, conventional weapon proliferation, which kill yellow, which leads to things like terrorism, as well as miscalculation, which ultimately implicates a nuclear war between and an all-out global nuclear war, which is obviously different from dying of natural causes because of things like radiation poisoning and asphyxiation that is inherent in a death from nuclear war. There are a couple of arguments they concede here. The first is the possession of war evidence, and it's a really good question. They think that governments have an obligation to preserve aggregate well-being. The specific warranted analysis is the statistical compassion argument indicates that every life has unique value, even if some are in a lower spectrum of the value of an overall value spectrum. The degree is relevant because as long as we solve for enough human life, we ultimately outweigh. The second argument is the aggregate well-being argument. It indicates you aggregate the life rather than doing it on a case-by-case basis, which means that we ultimately outweigh the case. The second argument is the Boston argument. It indicates that we're always going to have some degree of moral uncertainty, which means that even if you don't buy the results in the liberal argument, you have to default to an extinction calculus because ultimately extinction is not morally permissible for a governmental actor. Now, they conceded that, or actually, go to the TV. Counterinterpretation, developmental assistance is the aim used to promote economic development. That's the OECD evidence, the promotion of the economic development and welfare of a developing country is a concessional in character. Now, we meet our definition. We are promoting the economic development and the welfare of Venezuela, conceding that loans that are outstanding to the IMF. Our topic is comparatively better. We offer affirmatives that use other forms of developmental aid, key to other education outside of just grants, which are simple and easy and don't develop critical skills. They're also all the status quo, which means that debt cancellation would be specific to a topic area out at external of the regular topic literature. Now they overlook the topic and forget the core of the topic discussion. Now their interpretation is horrible. Kaimowitz allows for quote official flows like these in private development assistance, which means that A, there are other flows of wealth that can be classified as developmental aid, which means that we meet, and B, they allow for ask based on private company aid. Now also international organizations are comparatively better than individual countries' cooperation involves multilateral fiat, which is super abusive and necessitates a say yes argument on every country. Now we're topical. The IMF is the mechanism that sure off it all at nine. IMF is controlled by its wealthiest shareholders. It is supposed to be not plenty, and happens these countries control the countries controlling the fund can afford to impose a relatively pure set of ideological principles on other countries. Now go to the K. The negative is the status quo and or competitive governmental policy action. But best for education and fairness. Education, because we're confined to a limited space and time, there's a direct opportunity cost. Individual actors that do not use the state are insufficient to create social change. Debt to its fairness. It's most fair because if any focus on debate that is not around the plan text moves to one city, because we cannot defend every representation behind our author's assumptions or every social justice out there. Now let us weigh the affidavit of the K. The link and the impact remain at the top of the plan we have presented, which means that we should be able to weigh the over bear repercussions against the plan. The alternative only theory should come before the app, because the theory alters the structure of the round. The K isn't that, which means that we should be able to use the app to answer the K. Now, the app doesn't happen outside the round, and the judges and congressperson. Our argument is that if the app were to happen, it would solve extinction. It's net beneficial. Now, debates about simulation are good. Permutation to vote doesn't sever an intrinsic. They don't have a competitive advocacy. Permutation solves the link. Either they use fiat and there is an opportunity cost, or they simply analysis which can expose the error's policy while still creating material change from the app and the all other instances. Now, their link is one of omission. Links are links of ambition are not real links. Now, they claim that suffering is inevitable, and that intervention into suffering's life negating is nothing more than a thinly veiled cover for mass rape and genocide. In short, your version of life sucks. That's what Austin knows for Nietzsche. Sees himself making a healthy effort to apply for a life for Nietzsche, however, is written to claw in it, and his performance is also appalling and horrifying in relation to the other uses, which Nietzsche's idea were later, but he would effort which he cannot, and he would not care to do escape the blame when the left demands true democracy. All they really want is political dictatorship run by themselves. Defenders of Nietzsche these days also tend to have a communist communitarian democracy, which means that they would have more in common with the Nazis than Nietzsche himself. The model of morality of good and evil has been invented ever so among people who love it, and Nietzsche for his liberation of creativity to think of going away and beyond good and evil is merely legitimizing homosexuality, drugs, abortion, prostitution.
Mark that card as prostitution. You have 134.
Yeah. Okay.
It'll be KT in case. Or it'd just be KT.
Sorry, we'll make KT.
KT case, yeah. Okay. Are you good?
Can you top down?
It's just quickly on the K.
Okay,
We'll concede the permutation on the K. Prince of Justice has a competition. Now it's the T. External interpretation that an area of land that is controlled by its own government. They don't meet our interpretation. You just say that international organism is comparatively better because it involves wealthy nations that include a multitude of other nations as well, which basically means that you don't actually control it. And that means that there's a multitude of international organizations that can be used, which is super abusive, and that means it explodes limits because you can literally use any international organization that includes wealthy nations, which means it's literally impossible for us to predict. You say multi-actor fiat, however, limits outweighs multi-actor fiat because limits determine our ability to engage. First, your multi-actor fiat isn't abusive because it just allows for better debate, because we can imagine like hypothetical limitation. It doesn't give you a specific warrant as to why. It doesn't even give you a specific warrant as to why multi-actor fiat is abusive. He just says that it necessitates that, yes, however, that's just how fiat functions. Just allows for better debates on how policies work. However, limits literally stops us from engaging it, and you can also
also extend the you can also extend the interpretation of developmental assistance. His interpretation, his counterinterpretation isn't even competitive with our interpretation. Like, we literally talk about how yes, you can use econ assistance. However, you just can't. It can only include public transit with a grant element, and debt cancellation is not a grant alone. That was conceded across the debt. You're saying the violation, and the that means you can literally use any policy, and that explodes limits. We're not saying that you can't read econ assistance. We're just saying that you should we should limit it to these two. You say that grant doesn't allow for specific regulation. However, I literally asked you in process, like, how does debt cancellation function? You weren't even able to provide an answer. It probably means that you don't actually gain any substantive education from engaging in the debate or exploring multiple types of financial options. Means that there's no education from that argument. And the other argument that you say that you our interpretation is not precise. The Bilaber asked, however, no, it was a grammatical term. It just says that it referred used developmental assistance to refer to other flows like this, which still means that it involves public grants and loans. It just included that and also talked about private inflowing. However, that's a different definition where private company aid does not constitute development. Even if private company aid constitutes developmental assistance, it's not following inside the topic because it doesn't allow for those asks, because asks have to be by wealthy nations, which the other interpretation also solves for, which means that they can't defend a private company. That probably means our interpretations are specific enough, and also you explode limits. We'll go on to the standards debate. Extend limits limits are best for education. You conceded that limits are the greatest internal link to education and fairness. That was the argument made in the 1 NCU. Although you also conceded that we literally just have to read generics against every argument, which means that the negative is already at a disadvantage, and so we can't engage properly. The other argument that you conceded is that we as on the clash argument, because the app is prepared, which means that one-sided discussion. You conceded that we cannot rigorous testing of the app, which means that it's a net detriment to education, which means that even the arguments that you talk about, which say that we need to develop critical skills by talking about other education. If we can't test that, that means that we can't engage in this. You don't actually gain any education off that. And then you say that we overlimit the topic. However, no, there's a multitude of apps you can read here. We'll address the overlimiting argument on the developmental aid definition first. No, we say that you can develop any form of economic development as long as it is by a grant or it must constitute a grant or a public loan, which literally gives you a multitude of apps to talk about. Which means that it's not a form of you literally could have like defended like one of those two. That gives like two like Venezuela, that would have solved as a topical version of the app. And then also the other argument is that the overlimiting argument on the nations. However, no, there's literally, you could have picked any wealthy nation and that would have been sufficient enough, which means that gives you literally it gives you like 26 apps. That's clearly not overlimiting. We're just saying that you explode limits even more. That's the argument that you should be voting on today's debate, because you expand it to even more. You don't even read a counter interpretation here, which means that the only argument, which means you just make an I need argument here on the IMF. However, the IMF does not classify it because it's not owned. It does not own the land that is controlled by it, which means that you can see that you don't meet, which means that there's no counter interpretation on that shell, which means it flows through. You can extend that and it's the greatest internal link to fairness. And then now extend voters vote on fairness. For judges, job determining better education barriers, which is why we debate. Drop the debaters and turn and drop the argument. It's the same thing for T. Extend drop the debater. A dropping the argument. Same dropping the barriers. Together with the app as resource and deterrence. Extend competing interests reasonably leads to a race to the bottom. Since the people will put conflict to the line. Increasingly abusive arguments of reasonability is arbitrary, so we don't know what is reasonable. And I judgment mentioned on random unjust thresholds. Extend no RBIs. The action would be being topical of the other burden for doing something because the 1AC and T is a stock issue. So this is how the round breaks down. Literally, there are two interpretations that we say that we can develop developmental assistance. You say that the only argument you make on it is that it's not precise enough. However, we say no, it's in the context of developmental assistance, and the private company it makes no sense because it's in the context of wealthy nations. And the other argument that you make is that not precise cover, like however, it says that it still talks about public grants and loans, so it's specific enough, and it's also in the context of the OECD, which makes it specific enough. That's also where your definition is from. Your counter interpretation isn't competitive. You say you meet your definition. There's literally no impact to you don't bring any education, because I already asked you like the in-round question proves that like I asked you like what, how does this function? However, you weren't able to provide me a specific answer. I'm also not able to engage. Those are the greater internal links, and also limits is more important than multi-actor fiat, and you don't even give a reason why multi-actor fiat is bad. You say the IMF is a mechanism. However, first of all, you don't meet our interpretation. You don't have a counter interpretation.
35.
Just take. Alright, everyone good? Extend the counterinterpretation. That's the OECD evidence and indicates that developmental assistance is a promotion of economic development and welfare of developing countries and is conceptual in nature. We meet our definition. We're promoting economic development and welfare in Venezuela. Our topic is comparatively better because we allow for affirmatives that use other forms of developmental aid, whereas they overlimit out other forms. This is specifically critical to this topic because literally every affirmative that is germane to the question of developmental assistance will be in the form of grants, which means that our form of education is comparatively unique, which means you should evaluate more. They also conceded our indicted the camp votes, and it's specifically critical in this instance as well. It indicates that, quote, other flows like these in private developmental assistance could be allowed under their form of developmental assistance, which means that flows of wealth could be, which means that A, it's precise, and B, our flow of wealth could be technically classified as a form of developmental assistance. Even if you don't buy that, it's not precise enough. Our definition gives you a specific example as to what developmental assistance is, which means you should refer. Line by line. Their first interpretation that they extend is the nation's interpretation. However, there are a couple of answers to it. The first is that they say that we justify other international organizations. However, there are only a few institutions that owe debts to Venezuela, and they don't give a specific list as to what international organizations we allow for, which means that we technically do not. Also, our interpretation was germane to international organizations that include all wealthy nations, which is not many outside of the International Monetary Fund. They say that multi-actor fiat is good. However, there isn't an impact to this. Hypothetical implementation is not a warrant for why it is good. Multi-actor fiat is bad because it means that you have to have a say yes on every single country involved in the plan, which ultimately limits out a lot of affirmatives. And even if it doesn't, it's technically not legitimate because cooperation based on every single country would mean that eventually competing economic goals would get in the way of the cooperation and not solve the affirmative. Now they say that the developmental assistance interpretation. They say the counter. They say that it has to be public aid of grants. They conceded that the evidence allows for other forms of cash, which could be the affirmative is not precise. Also, they conceded that their interpretation allows for other institutions other than the governments, they conceded that their interpretation allows for other institutions other than the U.S. government. Their only bright line for this argument is that it has to be a body of people that own the land, which it could technically mean literally anything. They say that private company aid doesn't constitute wealthy nations. However, an app can cherry pick a definition of a group of people and then win the developmental assistance debate, which means it's super unpredictable and ultimately underlimits the topic, which links back to your arguments. They say that generics are bad. However, they don't give an impact to any of their generics argument. They say that we can never regress testing the affirmative. Every generic argument links to this, things like dependency, etc., which can still link to the affirmative, which means that you can still have a rigorous test of the affirmative. And given that you don't have an argument for why generics are bad, we can still meet your interpretation under the limits debate. They say that the IMF doesn't classify because it doesn't own the land. However, the IMF is an organization of nations. Your interpretation was of nations rather than an organization of nations, which means that because we're an organization of specific nations inside of it, we still technically meet the interpretation. US, EU, etc. all own the land that they're dropped around. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.